केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड इक्वेशंस। केमिकल रिएक्शंस। अ केमिकल रिएक्शन इज अ प्रोसेस इन विच सम सब्सटेंसेस अंडरगो बॉन्ड ब्रेकिंग एंड आर ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड इनटू न्यू सब्सटेंसेस बाय फॉर्मेशन ऑफ न्यू बॉन्ड्स। द सब्सटेंसेस टेकिंग पार्ट इन अ केमिकल रिएक्शन आर कॉल्ड रिएक्टेंट्स, वेयर एज द सब्सटेंसेस फॉर्म्ड एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ द केमिकल रिएक्शंस बाय फॉर्मेशन ऑफ न्यू बॉन्ड are called products. In 18th and 19th century, some of the scientists carried out fundamental experiments on chemical reactions. They proved from their experiments that during chemical reactions, composition of the matter changes and that change remains permanent. On the contrary, during physical change, only the state of the matter changes and this change is often temporary in nature. Talking about physical and chemical changes, a physical change takes place due to the change in the parameters such as temperature and pressure. A physical change is often reversible. The composition of the matter remains same in the physical change. And if composition of matter changes during a process, then it is called chemical change. When a particular process or phenomenon goes through a chemical change, some chemical reactions are taking place in the concerned matter. Now, let us see some basic day-to-day examples to understand physical and chemical changes. First, conversion from ice to water. When ice is turned into water, there is only physical change involved as only the state of the matter, that is ice, is changed. Second, ripening of fruit. When a fruit ripes, its taste and color changes, that is, its chemical property change. Third, evaporation of water. This reaction involves physical changes as the state of the water is changed from liquid to vapors. Rules of writing chemical reaction. Before going to the rules of writing a chemical reaction, let us see how to write a chemical reaction. Let us take it is a blue solution of copper sulfate and zinc dust. So the product that we get a colorless solution of zinc sulfate. Therefore, aqueous solution of copper sulfate plus zinc dust gives us aqueous solution of zinc sulfate plus copper. This simple way of representing a chemical reaction in words is called a word equation. A word equation can be written in a further condensed form by using chemical formulae as follows. CuSO4 plus Zn gives us ZnSO4 plus Cu. Now let us see some conventions of writing a chemical equation. In a chemical equation, the reactants are written on the left-hand side while the products are written on the right-hand side. An arrow heading towards the product is drawn in between them. This arrow indicates the direction of the reaction. If the reactants or products are two or more, they are linked with the plus sign in between them. To make the chemical equation more informative, the physical states of the reactants are indicated in the equation. The gaseous, liquid, and solid states are indicated by writing the letters G, L, and S respectively in the brackets. Moreover, if the product is gaseous, instead of G, it can be indicated by an arrow pointing upwards. When reactants and products are in the form of solution in water, they are said to be present in aqueous solution state. This state is indicated by putting the letters AQ in bracket after their formulae. When heat is to be given from outside to bring about a reaction, it is indicated by the sign triangle written above the arrow that indicates the direction of the reaction. It is necessary to fulfill certain conditions like specific temperature, pressure, catalyst, etc. to bring about some reactions. These conditions are indicated below or above the arrow indicating the direction of the reaction. Special information or names of reactants, products are written below their formulae. For example, here the reactant HNO3 is present in its concentrated state. Thank you for watching the Academic Squad.